The diagram of liquid looks something like this. Particles in liquid. So you see out here in liquid, you see there are some gaps between the particles. This is the reason why they have definite volume, but they do not have definite shape. That means it will be occupying volume, but they will not be having any shape. So if you put water into the bottle, it will become the bottle. If you put into the cup, it will become the cup. And if you put that water into the teapot, it will be teapot. But it doesn't have its own shape like that of solid. Solid has its own definite shape. Liquid does not have its own definite shape. The force of attraction is very much weak as compared to that of solid. So in this case, the force of attraction between the particles is much weaker as compared to that of solid. But not so weak. It is weak, but not so weak that particles does not distribute. So that's why they will be having definite volume. The reason the particle, because of space between the particles, these particles, they can move around freely. So as you can see the gaps around you, because the particles will be a bit loosely bounded, they can move everywhere, they can move freely. For this reason, it allows liquid to take any shape. This is the reason why liquid can take any shape, and the reason why liquid can flow, because there is a bit of space between the particles. Next one, gases. Now in case of gases, as you can see in the diagram, there is a huge space between the particles. That means the force of attraction between the particle is very weak. And this is the reason why gases do not have definite volume and definite shape. So the gases will not be having any definite volume. And another thing, they will not be having any definite shape. The particles between, there is a large space of particles, that large space of particles, space between the particles is very high, and all the particles will be moving freely here and there. So this reason says us that it will neither be having definite shape nor definite volume. Now we will be talking about solution. Now solution is any substance which is made by mixing two or more pure substance. So at home, if you are mixing sugar with water, the substance that it forms is known as a solution. The substance which will be formed after mixing sugar and water is your sugar solution. Sugar solution, and this gives rise to the solution. So a definition of solution will be: a solution is a mixture in which the component are spread uniformly. There are various type of solution. Here we will only discuss about liquid solution. So solution is are of many type, but for class, for your level, right now you will only be talking about liquid solution. Now in order to mix solution, two things are required, that is your solute and your solvent. Now the example which I gave you, you are making solution of sugar and water. So in that case, your sugar is your solute. Your sugar is a solute, the solid particles, sugar is your solute, and your water is the solvent. So whenever you are mixing sugar and water, that is whenever you are mixing solute and solvent, you are getting solution. So you are mixing sugar and water, and you are getting sugar water solution. That means solute and solvent, when they mix together, you are getting a solution. One thing we need to remember is, why is the reason water is known as the universal solvent? So here you can also see, water is called universal solvent. The reason why, because water is called universal solvent, is because it can dissolve more or less all the substance. They are very like maximumly may they are water can dissolve many substance. That's why it is known as your universal solvent. So the example which I gave you, sugar and water, so it is one example. It can also dissolve salt, it can also dissolve other substance. So this is the reason why water is known as universal solvent. So we'll be doing this much, and we'll continue the chapter later on. For now, thank you.